Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I am Quadricus Bernard Driscoll, and on this Monday May meditation, beloved friends, I lift up two prayers. The first prayer is for the world and mothers in particular. Will you pray with me? In you, our ancestors put forth their trust, and you delivered them. In you, they cried out and were saved. In you, they trusted and were not put to shame. And so we cry out, O God, right now for those mothers who have lost their children due to violence, death, and disease. We cry out to you, God, even in the midst of this pandemic. And we thank you. We thank you for the privilege of access to come before you and to make our requests known. You are the God of all flesh, and there is nothing or no thing too hard for you. And so we ask that you stretch forth your healing hand right now, that health might be restored and strength might be revived. By the power of your Spirit, make us whole again. Do it right now, God, and do it for your glory and for our good. We pray this in the one who is our strength and our Redeemer, and his name is Jesus. The second prayer, beloved, was inspired by Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 through 8. But I put a slightly different spin on it. And so will you hear the words of Ecclesiastes in the form of a prayer? For everything there is a season, and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be a baby, and a time to take last breaths. A time to till the soil and plant seeds of promise, and a time to weed out which is no longer life-giving or helpful. A time to eliminate self-hatred and blame, and a time to heal our broken hearts. A time to be in the chaos with family and friends, and a time to keep our own company. A time to dismantle systems that prevent the sick and the vulnerable from getting the care they need. A time to look for the helpers, as Mr. Rogers would say. A time to cry until our sides hurt and tears stream down our face. And a time to laugh until our sides hurt and tears stream down our face. A time to mourn those who reside on a more distant shore. And a time to dance like no one is watching. A time to celebrate the small things that spark joy. And a time to let go of the small things that get on our nerves. A time to cast away the stones of fear and xenophobia and racism and hatred. A time to build our life upon the foundation of love, grace, and mercy. A time to embrace the unknown. And a time to resist the all-consuming panic and dread. A time for hugging and passing the peace. And a time for social distancing. A time to speak up about what is important. And a time to give someone the benefit of the doubt. A time to hold fast to what is good in life. And a time to cast aside the fears of what others think. A time to tear up old narratives that no longer serve this present age. And a time to mend our relationships. A time to listen to God's still small voice. and a time to speak truth to power. A time for constructive conflict and a time for making amends. A time for death and a time for resurrection. God, we know that no matter what time or season we find our prayer, we come to you as authentically and as exposed as possible, knowing that you love us boldly, unconditionally, and abundantly. And for this, we say amen, hallelujah, and Ashe.